It is time for Debbie Downers. This is when we take a look back at the week that was on Fun 107's Facebook page, and we spotlight those Debbie Downers that just take the articles and take them to a negative place for really no apparent reason.
No, just to be crabby.
Yeah. So yesterday we did an article about Sonic and Somerset and how they're doing a pretty amazing deal, $1 hot dogs. You, Gazelle, took full advantage of that.
Yeah, and I actually did it.
You did it, the hot dog challenge?
I dedicated it to this guy right here. Go ahead.
Oh, you did? All right. Shane Mendonca writes, just to let you know, the World Health Organization has classified hot dogs as a level one carcinogen. On the same level of smoking cigarettes, beware of this before you feed it to your kids.
Listen.
Thanks, Shane.
I ate six in 6 minutes and I feel fine, okay? Everything's going to be okay.
It's just a hot dog, dude. It's one
hot dog.
Everything is a carcinogen.
Yeah, you're
going
to be okay.
You breathe.
Yeah, if you have a $1 hot dog one day this year.
We did a blog about how we're giving away tickets to see Taylor Swift at Gillette in July. Every day this week on the Michael Rock Show. They're not even on sale yet. So when you win them before you can buy them. El Unico Big Boy.
All right, first of all, no one is ever going to take you seriously with that Facebook name, homie.
El Unico Big Boy writes, yeah, but I bet the tickets are way in the back. Way, way back.
Oh, man.
Dude, the tickets aren't even printed yet. They don't go on sale until Wednesday.
Right, they don't even exist yet in real life.
Let's just
life.
Calm down about where the seats are, and there are people who are grateful just to get in the building. Do you have any idea how hard these tickets are?
Yeah, like, you will not be able to get any tickets. I don't care where in Gillette.
El Stinko.
Gazelle, you did an article about Applebee's and how they're doing a Long Island iced tea special for the month of December. $1 Long Island iced teas.
I'm liking this dollar affair that we're having lately,
causes
right?
causes a lot of anger.
Yeah.
There was a ton of pushback on that one.
People are just so mad about everything.
I could have picked any number of them, but we picked Ryan Flynn, who writes, gonna have more ice cubes and be watered down more than a Dunkin' iced coffee.
Oh, man.
Listen.
Long Island iced teas.
We understand if we're getting dollar Long Islands or dollar margaritas, that, like, they're not going to be top shelf.
You get what you pay for.
You're getting it for a dollar. Just go drink your Long Island.
It's just a fun little promotion,
yeah,
man. I mean, it's just
be happy with your $1.
Hey, don't bring Dunkin' into this. It did nothing wrong to you.
We did an article about Plymouth Plantation and how they're having their holiday stroll in the month of December. Lots of lights. It's a good old-fashioned family fun event. John Barlow, why do you keep spelling Plymouth wrong?
Seeing as I wrote this, I'll let you know. Because history, dude. That's how they spell it.
And that's actually how Plymouth Plantation spells it. P-L-I-M-O-T-H.
They spell it like the original Pilgrim
the
way.
The Old English, I believe it's
the
called.
The Pilgrims just didn't really get into the spelling thing too much.
Right, but thank you.
And neither should you.
After hearing the story, this is unbelievable.
Let's preface this.
There are two of them. These are holiday.
All right.
Holiday wish week Debbie Downers.
Let's
so, like,
say
this
we
is
almost,
a special kind of Debbie
we
Downer.
We almost weren't going to do them because we hated to put a Debbie Downer on Holiday Wish.
This first one, though, is. Okay, it is what it is. After hearing the story of the Pacheco family last week during Holiday Wish, the wait staff at Greasy Luck was so moved that they decided as a group to donate their tips to the widow of and her four kids to help make their Christmas a little bit brighter. That's happening all day today, by the way, Greasy Lock. You go there and just order and leave a tip, and all of that money goes to this family, the Pacheco family from New Bedford. Bill Booma Broom Better.
Where are you guys getting these Facebook names?
Booma Broom Better.
Who's doing this?
Bill writes, yeah, why doesn't the owner of the restaurant donate too? Well, Bill, some people don't, you know, broadcast and put up billboards about their donations. The owners are donating.
Yes.
More than you can imagine.
And the wait staff is taking a whole day of tips and donating it. So it's a nice thing.
A lot of people just donate kind of quietly.
Right.
Don't make a big deal out of it. This one, though, is the Debbie Downer of the week. This is the one that I almost didn't read on the air.
Hold on.
We posted a bunch of articles last week about all the families that we spotlighted during our Holiday Wish Week. And if you missed it, what it was our listeners and sponsors working together to help out local families living right here in the South Coast with serious issues like sick kids, sick parents, people that lost jobs, and all kinds
death
of
and
sad things. But
terrible,
like,
terrible things.
Our takeaway of this was, wow, what a nice world we're living in. All these people helping one another. Very inspirational, right? No, not for Ricky.
Wrong.
Ricky writes, I've seen donations to a family that didn't actually need it, but was nominated or picked. I don't know how you guys choose it, but it disgusted my outlook on helping.
Shut up!
Oh my goodness.
Ricky, we work with...
They didn't actually need it?
We work with the United Way of Greater New Bedford. They help us pick these families. They're a huge partner in this effort. But if that is what you're walking away with,
and you're disgusted, and now you're not going to help.
And now we're disgusted. Ricky.
Yeah.
If that is what you're walking away with, you win the Debbie Downer of the Week award here on Fun 107's Facebook page.
The Michael Knox Show, real fun in the morning. 107.1. Fun 107.